So this is the demonstration video of scapula. Scapula is a thin, flat, triangularly placed on posterior lateral aspect of thoracic cage. First of all, we'll do the site determination of scapula. All the processes of scapula should lie laterally. So this is the right, left side of scapula. It has two surfaces, three borders, three angles, and three processes. Two surfaces are the costal surface and the dorsal surface. Three angles are the inferior angle, the superior angle, and the lateral angle, which is formed by the glenoid cavity. Three processes are the coracoid process, the acromion process, and the spinous process. It has three fossa, the subscapular fossa, the supraspinous fossa, and the infraspinous fossa. The subscapular fossa contains the subscapular muscle, and the supraspinous fossa has supraspinatus muscle, and the infraspinous fossa has the attachment of infraspinatus muscle. Now let's talk about other muscles and its attachment. So first of all, we'll talk about the dorsal surface. The inferior angle has the attachment of latissimus dorsi. The superior angle has the attachment of levator scapulae, and the lower crest of spinous process has the attachment of deltoid muscle, and the upper crest of spinous process has the attachment of trapezius. So this also covers the acromion process. Trapezius muscle covers the superior border of the acromion process, and the deltoid muscle covers the inferior border of the acromion process. So there is the attachment of teres minor and the teres major in the lateral border of the scapula, and the medial border of the scapula has the attachment of rhomboid minor and the rhomboid major. Now we'll talk about the costal surface. So in the medial border of the costal surface, there is the attachment of serratus anterior. Now we'll talk about the processes and the muscles attached to it. So this is the coracoid process. It has the attachment of short head of coracobrachialis. So now we'll talk about the processes and the muscles attached to it. So this is the coracoid process. It has the attachment of short head of biceps and coracobrachialis muscle. So the short head of biceps and coracobrachialis muscle arises from the tip of the coracoid process. Now we'll talk about the glenoid cavity. So glenoid at the superior angle of the glenoid cavity has two tubercles. This is supraglenoid tubercle and the infraglenoid tubercle. Supraglenoid tubercle has the attachment of long head of biceps, and infraglenoid tubercle has the attachment of long head of triceps. So here it is, there is the presence of suprascapular notch, which has the attachment of superior border near the suprascapular notch has the attachment of inferior belly of homoid muscle. Now we'll talk about the ligaments. So glenoid cavity has the attachment of capsule of shoulder joint and the glenoid labrum. Now we'll talk about the ligaments. So there's a presence of coracoclavicular ligament, which is the ligament between distal end of clavicle to acromion. Coraco-acromion ligament, lateral border of coracoid process to the medial border of acromion process. Coraco-humeral ligament, root of coracoid process to the humerus. Coraco-clavicular ligament are of two types. One is attached to the conoid, and other is attached to the trapezoid tubercle. Then there is a suprascapular ligament. Suprascapular ligament is attached to the suprascapular notch, which converts it into the foramen, into which the suprascapular nerve passes. Then there is a spinoglenoid ligament, which bridges the spinoglenoid notch. Thank you.